Feminism is cancer. Feminists hate men. Feminists are aggressive. Feminists blame the patriarchy for everything. Feminists are stupid. Feminists are overly sensitive. Feminists are dykes. Feminists are judgmental and close-minded. Feminists are radical and extreme. Feminists are all really feminazis. Does this sound like feminism to you? Because it's not. Feminism is a fight for equality. Feminism is equal opportunity. Feminism is empowerment. My name is Maya Blaisdell, and welcome to my TED Talk.
It's the bottom big button.
It's the bottom. Okay, there you cool. go. So I researched the question, how has feminism evolved, and what is the current role of feminism in the United States? And when I was growing up, I grew up with feminism. My grandmother and my mother are both committed feminists. And since I could read, I've been reading books about the movement and the women who made these movements happen. As soon as I was allowed to form my own school projects, they were all about feminism. And I know that I wouldn't be the person I am today without the empowerment that feminism gave me. So what is feminism? Feminism is a movement that fights for the complete equality of all people, regardless of gender, race, sexual orientation, class, or ability. Although it is based in equality for women, it has evolved into a movement for everyone. The overall purpose of feminism is to dismantle the patriarchal society in the United States. Feminism in the US is divided into three main waves. The first wave, which occurred in the 1800s, the second wave, which started in the 1960s, and the third wave, which is the current feminist movement, and started in the 1990s. So first wave feminism began in the 1840s, and it sparked the entire movement. At the time, women were not allowed to vote, they were not allowed to speak publicly without ridicule, and they were considered the property of their husbands. People believed that women had smaller brains than men, and therefore were not considered as intelligent or capable, which, thankfully, people have come to their senses and and women were seen as delicate and incapable of equal intellectual ability to men. Feminists like Susan B. Anthony and Elizabeth Cady Stanton stood up against these horrible discriminations by fighting for their right to vote, hosting conventions that discussed women's rights, and fighting for women to be considered complete and independent members of society. The first wave was mostly a fight for basic equal rights. So second wave feminism is what most people think of when they think of the feminist movement. This movement started in the 1960s and continued through the 1980s. It was a time when women were fighting for reproductive rights, including access to birth control and safe legal abortions. Abortion in the United States was illegal until 1973, and before that, women had to resort to incredibly unsafe and horrible ways of getting abortions. And before access to birth control and abortion, women did not have full control over their bodies. If a woman had an unwanted pregnancy, there was nothing she could do about it. This access allowed women to have complete control over their lives. Another major issue in this movement was equal representation in the workplace. At the time, people believed that women were supposed to remain in the home and cook, clean, and look after children. Women were not encouraged to have careers. They were expected to go to college to find husbands who would take care of them financially while they stayed home and took care of the house. Feminists believed that women had more to offer and that in order to lead fulfilled lives, women should have careers. Like the first wave, the second wave feminists fought hard for women to be considered complete contributing members of society. The third wave started in the 1990s, and it's considered the current feminist movement. The third wave followed in the footsteps of the first and second waves, which laid the groundwork for the current movement. Women no longer have to fight for their right to vote or to own property. Now we are able to focus on shifting society as a whole. The purpose of this movement is to create an inclusive and accepting culture where all people are treated equally. Despite the incredible work past feminists have done, there's so much more work to do. Women are still sexually harassed and assaulted daily. Safe, legal abortions are becoming increasingly hard to come by, and men are still paid more on average than women. Each of these examples are products of the patriarchal society that we live in, and this is what third wave feminism is fighting against. So intersectionality is one of the main pieces of third wave feminism, and it's the idea that each person has many different identities, including gender, race, religion, sexual orientation, class, and many others. Intersectional feminism looks at all aspects of a person and determines the movement from that. As Audre Lorde said, there is no such thing as a single-issue struggle because we do not live single-issue lives. If the feminist movement only focused on the identity of women while ignoring everything else, the movement would exclude so many people who would greatly benefit from this movement. So feminism has evolved to fit the current needs of women. The role that feminism played in the 1800s is not the same role that it plays now, and it shouldn't be. There are different issues now than there was then. The reason the feminist movement has lasted this long is that it is able to become whatever movement is needed. Right now, feminism has taken the form of promoting intersectionality and inclusivity as a way of dismantling the patriarchy. So feminism is incredibly important today. There are a lot of misconceptions about third wave feminism, especially that it is no longer relevant. This movement is absolutely still relevant. There's so much more work to do in terms of reproductive rights, rape culture, and the respect of women. The second wave fought for reproductive rights, but since abortion was legalized, states have been passing laws that limit women's access. In some states, it's close to impossible to obtain an abortion, especially for people under 18. People protest outside Planned Parenthoods every day. Women are harassed as they try to enter these clinics. Planned Parenthood, by the way, does so much more than abortion. Only about 10% of what they do is abortions, and the rest is education and other health-related services. And it's horrible that people only think of abortion when they think of an organization that does so many amazing things. And women are still not respected by our society or culture. And this is shown by the fact that Donald Trump was elected as president. The Trump administration poses a major threat to the feminist movement and women as a whole. The man running our country has been accused multiple times of sexual harassment and assault, yet he was still elected to office. This is a disgusting example of how little women are respected and taken seriously, and it needs to stop. We cannot continue to contribute to a society that does not fully respect women. So last January, my grandmother, my sister, and I flew to Washington, D.C. to attend the Women's March. This was one of the most powerful experiences I've ever had. It was amazing to be around so many people committed to making this country what it needs to be. Many of us felt disheartened after the presidential election last year, and this march was a time to act in solidarity with each and every individual in this country. I felt so fortunate to have the opportunity to be involved with a movement that truly creates necessary change, and this movement has continued. There was another march this year, and there will be many more in the years to come. This will be a yearly reminder of the progress we have made and the work we still have to do. In order to move forward, feminism must be intersectional and inclusive. This is a movement for all people, and those who say otherwise are not feminists. This movement is for everyone, and it needs to stay that way. So please, make sure your feminism is inclusive, intersectional, and promotes complete equality. Thank you.